Donald Trump has built his campaign a little bit around the idea that he can't be bought. Let's listen to something he said just about this idea of who's owning the elections.
I'm not doing what's right for a man that gave me $1 million to run for office, and I owe him. And when Bush gets $100 million plus, and when Hillary gets $50 million plus, every one of those people that put up money will control Bush. Control, I don't mean like a little bit. Bush is controlled by those people. Walker is controlled by those people. Hillary Clinton is controlled by those people.
So, Stephen, let me ask you about this, because what Donald Trump is touching on, whether you agree with the specifics of his claim, is something that we see in our polls again and again, that people basically think that money calls the tune and that it's a small group of people calling the tune. You actually have talked to people donating to groups. What does it look like from your vantage point?
Sure. First of all, I mean, I have to comment on the irony of a multi-billionaire like Donald Trump, who's self-financing his campaign, complaining about the amount of money in politics, but I'll leave it to him to sort out that irony. But no, it's true. I mean, we do spend a lot of time talking to donors. I actually talk to people on the other side of the coin, Democrats who talk to donors. And most donors, the vast majority of them, are motivated by a desire to see the direction of the country change in a broad way. They're concerned, in our case, they give to Crossroads because they're concerned about the direction of the country, a flatline economy. They're concerned about where Hillary Clinton would take the country. And they are hoping to invest in us to try to change that scenario. I read with interest some of the comments from people who had given to the Right to Rise organization. Mike Fernandez, the largest donor, says the thing he feels passionately about, he disagrees strongly with Jeb Bush on, which is normalization of relations with Cuba. So what people are doing is they're investing in a chance to change the country, and that's how they view it, and that's, again, what motivates people on both the left and the right.
Right to Rise being the super PAC for Jeb Bush, one of these outside groups that runs in parallel to his actual campaign. Juliana.
Well, it's interesting with Right to Rise, one of the data figures that they boasted was that 95% of their donations were $25,000. Or less. So it just shows you where we have come from 4 years ago when you have campaigns, part of the other system that Matteo was talking about, boasting of donations, of small dollar donations of $200 or $250 or less. But that is the big question this cycle, and it's what the chair of the FEC says, is that it's going to be very difficult to know whether certain candidates are taking certain policy positions, because that is what is being pushed by a multimillionaire, billionaire backer writing seven-figure checks.